After all those wild nights in college, who would have guessed that the nastiest thing that you would take out of it with no cure in sight is student loans? $1.7 trillion of student loan debt is outstanding, with close to 45 million borrowers carrying some level of student loan debt. Roughly 70% of the class of 2019 graduated with some form of student loan debt of almost $30,000 on average. It's absolutely mind-boggling the amount of student loan debt that is out there. There are numerous proposals that have been given to try and eliminate student loan debt in 2021. In this video, I want to talk briefly about these and see how it might impact your finances as we move forward and what we can do to overcome student loan debt, to be able to move forward and move on. My name's Frank Cho. If we haven't met before, on this channel, we talk about personal finance, investing in cryptocurrencies. I'm here to help you live a richer life. And if any of those topics sound interesting to you, hit that subscribe button so that I can keep you informed and that we can learn and grow together as we seek to have a richer, more abundant life. That being said, let's jump right into it. So in the stimulus bill that was just passed, there was a provision included for forgiveness of student loan debt over the next 5 years to be tax-free. So this is important to understand because the groundwork has already been laid for student loan forgiveness to actually happen. Now, there are conflicting proposals where you have certain senators, Elizabeth Warren and Chuck Schumer, for instance, who have proposed $50,000 in student loan forgiveness. Now, President Biden has shot this down recently in a town hall meeting where he has said, I will not do $50,000, but $10,000 is a number that he has considered more feasible, more acceptable, but he's looking to Congress to pass something there versus using executive action on his own. Many people have suggested that this is within his capability to do, to forgive this student loan debt. This is an issue in that you have a position on the government's balance sheet that you're essentially just wiping out. So they are no longer able to collect this. So the question is, you know, where does this money come from? How do we offset this? Is there a tax increase? What things will lead up to this? And who's really paying for this? Is it coming out of the pockets of people who didn't even go to college? Are they being forced to pay for the tuition of people who did? Is this fair to people who have been to college and graduated and paid off their debt? So there's a lot of issues around this topic that are important. For the sake of this video, I want to talk more about what the forgiveness would look like in 2021 and how it might impact your financial situation. So taking the $50,000 totally off the table, because our president has said that he's not willing to go that far and sign that if it came to his desk, we assume then that $10,000 is probably more likely to happen. Still, nothing is guaranteed. We've seen what happened with the stimulus bills where there's been multiple proposals and things have been back and forth in Congress and nothing really happened for a period of time until finally we did get some things passed, but with certain restrictions and with certain thresholds in place. Now, as we think about student loan forgiveness this year, I think it's important to understand that they will probably put some kind of income cap on this. So if you are a high-earning individual, there's a high likelihood that there will be some level of phase-out like we saw with the original stimulus bills, or even this newer one where it's even lower, that will restrict the amount of forgiveness that someone's able to get. Let's take a quick listen on a few of the topics that have come up straight from the voices of those who are debating these very issues as we go through the year.
Today, I want to talk about student loan debt. About 43 million Americans now carry $1.5 trillion in student loans. That's more than Americans owe in auto loans or credit card loans. And that burden of debt is stopping people from buying homes or starting businesses. It's holding our whole economy back. So I want to ask you about who these student borrowers are. Some people have argued that people with student loans are lawyers and doctors who took out debt to go to fancy schools. Professor Atkinson, is that an accurate picture of who has student loans?
Good morning, Senator Warren. It is not an accurate picture. If anything, if we think about fancy schools, and I'll insert here the Ivy League schools to, you know, as example of fancy schools, debt loads are among the smallest among those graduates from those schools. And some of it has to do with those schools have the resources to support students, right? They don't, you know, or else they enroll students who themselves have resources. So instead, some of the schools that tend to have the highest level of debts are regional schools. Alabama State University, 89% of students leave with an average of $54,000 in student debt. And I want to focus on the word leave. It doesn't mean that they leave with a degree, right? They leave. And so it runs the gamut of community college students, for-profit students, traditional four-year college students, students who are just, you know, believing what we've told them, that if you go out and get an education, your life can be better. And what they get instead is debt.
Thank you so much. That's very powerful. You know, canceling student loan debt would expand opportunities for millions of people and would provide a massive stimulus for our economy. Dr. Hamilton, you've written that canceling student loan debt is one of the quickest actions the president could take to narrow the racial wealth gap. So can you tell us how student loan debt cancellation would help level the playing field and whether or not canceling $10,000 of student loans is enough to accomplish that goal?
First, I hope that Congress acts to cancel student loan debt, but part of the reason why it's one of the quickest actions, because I think that the president can do it through executive action as well. But in the context, maybe we could talk about millennials. During the last Great Recession, we asked millennials to wait out a struggling job market and go to school to better themselves, to get better credentials. And they came out with record levels of debt. If we look at millennials when they were 30 years old in the context of previous generations, they had the lowest home ownership rate as every other generation, dating all the way back to the greatest generation that was coming out of the Great Depression. And what's more, the racial disparity and home ownership amongst millennials is as large as it's ever been since we've ever been recording the data. So on the one hand, it's immoral when we tell people this is your pathway for upward mobility. Then we saddle them with debt that limits their capacities to get other forms of assets so that they can accumulate wealth. So prospectively, we're looking at a generation that came out of the Great Recession, and now we're about to scar them with this pandemic recession. So we certainly need government to act to change their reality. And it's not just millennials. We have people collecting Social Security that are still paying student debt. So this is a moral justice issue that has disparate racial effects. And in the 21st century, it's sad that we're still talking about financing a debt-free college education for all Americans.
As you know, Leader Schumer and I have a plan to cancel $50,000 in student loan debt. So let me just ask you, how much progress would that make in helping close the racial wealth gap in America?
I'm for full cancellation, but if the practical reality is 50, it's a lot better than 10,000, especially when we consider the fact that on average, 4 years after graduation, a Black graduate has about $50,000 in debt in relation to $30,000 for a white graduate, which is also entirely intolerably too high.
Thank you very much. You know, canceling $50,000 of student loan debt is the single most effective executive action available to get our economy going and to make progress toward closing the racial wealth gap. And I hope President Biden decides to do this.
I hope this video was helpful for you. If you found some value here, hit that subscribe button and come back so that we can talk more about how personal finance and investing can help you to live a richer and more fulfilled life. Drop me a like on the video and leave me a comment below. Let me know what your thoughts on student loan forgiveness are. If you think it's something that we should be pursuing as a nation, or if it's something that we need to say, hey, everybody's accountable for those decisions that they made. I don't know that there's a right or wrong opinion on this topic, but I do want to know what yours is. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you being here. We're closing in on 1,000 subscribers, and I couldn't be here without you. Thank you so much. I'll see you next time.